Good morning, children. I welcome you to the fourth lecture of the chapter Circles. Please bring your book and textbook. Question number 6 is the length of tangent from a point A, this is the point A and this is the length, at distance 5 cm from the center of the circle is 4 cm. So the distance is 5 cm from center and tangent is 4 cm. We need to find the radius. Now I will only give you the hint for this question, because OPA is a right angle triangle as angle P is 90 degrees. It is an angle between radius and tangent. So we can use Pythagoras theorem here. THM is the short form of the word theorem, which says that hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Hypotenuse is the longest side, so 5 square is equal to radius square plus 4 square. Now after this, you will do rest of part by yourself. For full solution, you can refer to any other YouTube channel also. Like last time I told you green board, there is another channel which is known as eVidyarthi or Mathematics Online. Now question number 7 is, there are two concentric circles. The word concentric means co-centers, means the two circles which share a common center are known as concentric circles. You must have seen these type of figures on archery board. Like in the figure, both the circles, they have the common center O. Now OB is the radius of the bigger circle, which is given as 5 cm. OA will become the radius of the smaller circle, that is 3 cm. Now he says that find the length of the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. So BC here is the chord for the larger circle and it becomes the tangent for the smaller circle, as it is touching it only at the point A. Now the hint here is angle A is 90 degrees, because it is the angle between radius and tangent for smaller circle. So triangle OAB will become a right angled triangle. So the hint starts like this. Triangle OAB is right angled at A. So OB will become hypotenuse. By Pythagoras theorem, OB square is equal to OA square plus BA square, that is hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Now hypotenuse is the radius of the bigger circle, so it is 5 plus 3 square plus base square. So we need to find base by solving this equation. After you will solve the base, BC will be 2 times BA. Why? Because in class 9th we have studied that if you draw a perpendicular from the center to the chord, it will always bisect the chord. Bisection means dividing into two equal parts. This way BA will become half of BC. or BC will become twice of BA. Best of luck with this sum. Now let us come to a very important question, question number 8 of the exercise. This question has come many times. Now before doing this question, let us note down the statement of the theorem 10.2, which says that tangents from an external point to the circle are equal in length. I hope you must remember, which we have proven with the help of congruency rules. That was RHS rule. Now children, we are given a quadrilateral ABCD, which is circumscribing a circle. Circumscribing means it is fully covering the circle. Its all four sides are touching the circle. Now we need to prove that AD plus BC is equal to AB plus CD. That is, the sum of opposite sides of this quadrilateral are equal. Now let us start with the proof or the solution. Now children, let us consider the point A. If you say A is nothing but an external point to the circle, and AP and AS are two tangents which are starting from A. This way, I am only drawing that much portion. So from A, AP and AS are two tangents like this. Now by the theorem, their length must be equal. Therefore, we can say AP is equal to AS. Now consider point B. Similarly, I can say BP is equal to BQ. Again, two tangents from an external point. Now this is for point A. And the last one is for point B. Similarly, now consider point C. So I can say that CR is equal to CQ. Similarly, for point D, it will be DR is equal to DS. Now we will add all the four equalities such that every length which is on the left hand side of equality will come together, and every length which is on the right hand side will come together. So I can say AP plus BP plus CR plus DR, which is on left hand side, is equal to AS plus BQ plus CQ plus DS. Now if we see carefully, AP and BP, they are part of the same line segment. Similarly, CR and DR, they are also part of same line segment. Here BQ and CQ, and similarly AS and DS. Now if I add AP and BP, and I see from figure, the bigger line segment which they are forming is AB. Similarly, CR and DR, they are forming CD. AS and DS become AD, and BQ plus CQ will become BC. Hence, we have proved that the sum of opposite sides is equal. Now children, there is another question, that is question number 11. which says that prove that the parallelogram circumscribing a circle is a rhombus. Now for this question, first of all you have to write down the full solution of question number 8. After that, from this step you will move to this step, that because we know that ABCD is a parallelogram, it means its opposite sides must be equal. This is the property of a parallelogram. It means AB must be equal to CD. And AD must be equal to BC. So, in the equality which we have proven, instead of CD, I can write AB because they are equal. So, it will become AB plus AB is equal to similarly AD plus AD. So 2 times AB is equal to 2 times AD. 2 is cut. So AB is equal to AD. Now if we see AB and AD carefully, they are adjacent sides. It means if adjacent sides are equal, and already we are given opposite sides are also equal, henceforth we can say that all the sides are equal. And a parallelogram where all the sides are equal is known as rhombus. So all sides are equal. It implies ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, children. So this question is very important. Now this part you have to add in the solution of question number 11 along with the solution of question number 8. Don't include this part for question number 8. Your question number 8 finishes here. So children, best of luck for these 4 questions. We will meet in the Zoom meeting to discuss your doubts. Thank you.